Hello friends, welcome to Oliveboard. I hope you're all doing well and your exam preparations are going good too. In this video, we are going to discuss the most important GK questions for the month of December. This is part 9 of the series. If you've not watched any of the previous parts, by the end of the video on the end screen, you can find the playlist to access all the parts. Before we start with the video, don't forget to take up a free mock test for any banking or government examination that you are preparing for by clicking on the link given to you in the description box. So do take up a free mock test, take expert advice, know your strengths and your weaknesses, and structure your exam preparations accordingly. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel for latest videos. Recently notified Kuno National Park is located in which Indian state? So from the following options, what is the correct answer? It is option 3, which is Madhya Pradesh. So Kuno is located in Madhya Pradesh and has recently been notified as a national park. So it has 748.7618 square kilometer of an area, and it fought a legal battle over issue of the relocation of the Asiatic lions from the Gir to Kuno. So after the commitment given by Supreme Court, it has been accorded the status of a national park, and now this will pave the way for the introduction of lion at the Kuno National Park. We know that in the entire world, Asiatic lion is found only in India, and that too in the Gir National Park or in Gujarat. So now to preserve these lions, we want to relocate them to few different locations, and one of that is the Kuno National Park in Madhya Pradesh. Who amongst the following has won the top debater in the world title in the junior category at Yale University? So from the following options, the correct answer is option 4, which is Adi Sai Vijayakaran, who has created history by winning this junior debate championship at Yale University. The theme of this year's cup was an entangled world, diplomacy, human relationships, the science of memory and literature, art and music. And Adi Sai Vijayakaran has won this title. Recently, EY, which is Ernst & Young, one of the big four CA firms in India or audit firms in India, has acquired a Pune-based digital design company. So which amongst the following is the company that has been acquired by ENY? The correct answer is option 1, which is Fortune Cookie, which is a user experience design firm and headquartered in Pune, has been acquired by ENY. So at a time when the clients are seeking towards digital transformation, this acquisition by ENY will add a diverse set of digital capabilities to the service line which is provided by ENY. Recently, one amongst the following has become the youngest woman to reach the 50 World Cup wins in alpine skiing. Who amongst the following is that? The correct answer is option 4, which is Michaela Schifrin, who hails from America and has become the youngest woman to win 50 World Cup in alpine skiing. And this victory is in the slalom in the French Alps. Now, she has become the first woman to secure half century of race victories before her 24th birthday. Hence, the youngest woman ever to reach half a century World Cup wins. Which amongst the following companies has planned to invest 100 crores rupees to add 80 stores in India? The correct answer is option 2, which is NISA Retail Group, which operates the One Indian Family Mart retail chain, and they have planned to invest around 100 crore rupees to add 80 stores and are aiming for a turnover of 1100 crores by the year 2021, and the company is led by JP Shukla and Ravinder Singh, and it began its operations in the year 2013 in India. Who amongst the following has been appointed as the Deputy Chief of Integrated Defence Staff? The correct answer is option 1, which is Rajiv Sachdeva, who is an Air Marshal and has taken over as the Deputy Chief of the Integrated Defence Staff Operations. Now, he has distinction of the earlier serving in 3 out of the 4 wings of the Headquarter Integrated Defence Staff. So remember, this is very, very important. It is Rajiv Sachdeva. RBI has mandated the cooling period of how many years for the post of CEO or any equivalent post for all the officers or the retired officers? The correct answer is option 3, which is 3 years. So it has come up with a new norm for all the top officials who want to take up a job of either a chairman or chief executive or any other entity post their requirement, and it has mandated a 3-year cooling off period for any such positions. So now any officer who gets retired from RBI need to wait for at least 3 years to take up any other job for the post of a chairman or chief executive or any equivalent post. Recently, USA has ordered the withdrawal of its troops from which amongst the following countries? The correct answer is option 5, which is Syria. And the US troops will now leave the civil war racked country when they have been deployed to assist the multinational fight against the Islamic State jihadists group. So all the American troops will leave Syria. The National Consumer Day is celebrated every year on which date? So from the following options, what is the correct answer? It is option 2, which is 24th of December every year is being celebrated as National Consumer Day with a specific theme. So this year the theme was timely disposal of consumer complaints, and the Consumer Protection Act for the year 1986 was also passed on 24th of December. Recently, Hamidi Kashmiri passed away. He is associated with which of the following fields? The correct answer is option 2, which is Urdu literature. So Hamid Kashmiri is the tallest literary figure in the world of Urdu language, literature and literary criticism, and he passed away recently. He was the propounder of Iktishafi Tanqeed, and he's also been the vice chancellor of the University of Kashmir for years during the most difficult times of militant unrest. Dwijing festival is organized in which amongst the following Indian states? The correct answer is option 4, which is the state of Assam. So the third Dwijing festival recently began on the bank of A river in the Chirang district of Assam, and around 15 lakh tourists are expected to participate in the festival. Adventure sports, food mart, cultural events, traditional games, etc. are also being organized in the 12-day long event of the Dwijing festival. Recently, which amongst the following state government has implemented the 7th pay commission recommendation? The correct answer is option 5, which is the state of Maharashtra, that has recently implemented the recommendations of the 7th pay commission. And this will benefit all the officers, employees, teachers from unaided schools and those from Zilla Parishad institutions, because they will get a hike in their present salary. Atal Ayushman Uttarakhand Yojana will provide medical treatment up to what amount to each household in Uttarakhand? The correct answer is option 5, which is 5 lakh. So this has been launched in the state of Uttarakhand, and under this scheme, every household will be able to avail medical treatment up to 5 lakh rupees annually, and this will benefit around 23 lakh households in Uttarakhand. Recently, Russia has put economic sanctions in which of the following countries? The correct answer is option one, which is Ukraine, and they have expanded this economic sanctions, adding more than 250 people and businessmen to the blacklist. Also, relationship between Moscow and Kyiv have deteriorated since the pro-Western government came into power after the year 2014. GST Anti-Profiteering Authority, which is the National Anti-Profiteering Authority, has recently found which amongst the following companies guilty of illegal profiteering. The correct answer is option 2, which is Hindustan Unilever Limited. And it, the National Anti-Profiteering Authority has found that they were not passing on the rate cut benefits of around 383 crore rupees to the consumers. So the GST rate on a large number of products was cut from 28% to 18%, and still the Hindustan Unilever Limited had not reduced prices of many of the products. Recently, which amongst the following countries withdrew itself from the International Whaling Commission? The correct answer is option 5, which is Japan, that withdrew its membership from the International Whaling Commission and is resuming the commercial whaling in a move that is expected to spark international criticism. This withdrawal means that Japan now joins Iceland and Norway and will defy the International Whaling Commission's ban on commercial whale hunting. India has recently inaugurated the Information Fusion Center for the Indian Ocean Region nations. So where was this inaugurated? In which of the following cities? The correct answer is option 3, which is Gurugram. So our Defense Minister Nirmala Sitharaman inaugurated this Information Fusion Center for all the countries in the Indian Ocean region for information sharing and capacity building. And this center is located at Gurugram. Recently, Google honored the late social worker and reformer on his 104th birth anniversary with a doodle. So who amongst the following is that? The correct answer is option 2, which is Baba Amte, who is a late social worker and reformer, and he was honored with a Google Doodle by Google. He spent his life serving leprosy patients and working for their rehabilitation, and he also founded a commune called Anandvan Ashram in Maharashtra. Who amongst the following has been appointed as India's chief boxing coach? The correct answer is option 1, which is C.A. Katappa, who is a Dronacharya awardee, and he has taken over as India's chief boxing coach. He took over the charge from the veteran coach S.R. Singh, and he is credited with shaping some of the country's most successful boxers like Vijendra Singh, M. Suryanjoy Singh and various others. Recently, one amongst the following cricketers has been inducted into the ICC Hall of Fame. Who is it? The correct answer is option 1, which is Ricky Ponting, who is the former Australian captain, and he has formally been inducted into the ICC Cricket Hall of Fame. To mark this occasion, Ponting received his commemorative cap from the compatriot ICC Cricket Hall of Famer Glenn McGrath. Oliveboard has launched the SBI PO Cracker course, which is an online live course which starts from 29th of January. Herein we'll have 100 plus hours of live classes and practice sessions. We also have one-on-one video doubt clearing sessions with the expert faculty of Oliveboard, and we'll have live classes for quants, English, reasoning and general awareness. To enroll for the SBI PO Cracker course, please click on the link which is given to you in the description box. That's all we have for you in this video. I hope you liked the video. Do share it with your friends who are also preparing for banking and government examinations. And if you've not subscribed to our YouTube channel yet, go ahead and subscribe now to not miss any videos from Oliveboard. Thank you.